So hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you how to implement head Linux command by using a C program. So currently I have my Dev C++ editor and I will just type the code here and copy and paste it in replate Linux, so which creates a Linux terminal online. So you don't need to have an Linux OS to do. So I will code it and I will also show you a live demo using this one. So let's get started. So head command basically displays that. By default, this displays 10 lines of a particular file, and you can change the number of lines as per you wish. So, but in this code, I'm going to go by default. That is, if you use the head command, this program, it will display just 10 lines of contents of the person in the file. So let's get started. So start with the header file. Okay, it's going to be ash include stdio.h and void main. Okay, so we are going to pass the file name in the command inform. So it's going to be int argc, which is the argument count, and char asterisk argv, which is the argument itself. So it's in the form of array. I think you'll be familiar with it. So for those who don't know, this is the argument count. That is a count of the argument. So if you enter 2, it's going to be 2. And this is that argument itself. So suppose file name means it's considered as an argument. So now let's get the file as an input. So file data type file. File asterisk, let's name our file as f, okay, and let's open it. So f equal to f open, and so we're just going to pass the name of the argument as the file name. So it's going to be argv of 1, because argv of 0 is going to be dot slash header out, that is used to view the output. So that's going to take the argv of 0th index. And our file name is going to be a second argument, and that's going to be the first index. Okay, and we're just going to read it. We're not going to do any changes, just read. So it's in the read mode. So that's very good. And now we are just going to use an if condition to check whether we have inputted two arguments correctly, that is a dot slash editor on the file name, or whether our file exists. So for that file, so this checks that our file exists and it's actually a file, proper file format. If this not file represents, it will be null. Okay, if our file is not existing or it's not in a proper format, it will return run null, and our if command, if statement inside if, will be executed. So we will be using R over here. So if file is not present or argument count is not equal to 2, so we need two arguments, as I told you earlier. One argument is a dot slash header out and it's a file name. So we just print something. So you can even skip this code just for to make it more professionalized way. So you are doing this. Okay, so something went wrong like that, some errors. Okay, like that, something printed. And so here the main code starts from. Okay, so it's going to be int n equal to 10. Okay, this n equal to 10 basically corresponds to the default value of it. It displays 10 lines, or first 10 lines of a file's content. And we're going to use char. So it's going to be char line. And let me say some around. I will name it as some 100. You can name it, depends on the file size, because 100 it's going to be array of characters. So if you have a very large file, you can give it as 1000, 10,000 as your wish. So here I'm just going to show you as a demo. I'm going to have a very less number of characters. So use a while loop, okay? While, and we are going to use fgetters to get the character from the file. So it's going to be fgetters. Okay, and the condition is going to be in this form. So first line, okay, this is a character that we're going to extract from the file, and next the number of lines. So it's going to be size of, okay, size of operator is used to find the, how to say, number of bytes, or the extract the line count of the lines. Okay, and next thing is going to be the file stream. So our file stream is going to be f, the source where we are going to extract. So thing extra this bracket. Okay. Yes, that's good, I think so. So this is the condition. Get f getters, it gets the characters from the line. So line is the character of array, that we have passed, and size of is the count of the lines, and f is the file stream. Okay, so to know about more f getters, just check it on the web. Okay, and next thing is what we are going to do is, so we are just going to display 10 lines. Okay, so if our condition is, we are going to just decrement because of our n value is 10. So if n equal to 0, we need to just break out of this loop. Okay, if n is equal to 0, just break the loop. Okay, and if n is in 0, until then we are going to just print our lines. Okay, so it's going to be printf percentage s comma our character array line, that's it. Okay, and here n minus minus, by default n value is going to be decremented, and once it reaches n equal, so first 10 lines will be printing, So, and after 10th, the in will be 0 and our while loop will get terminated and the program will end. So, that's basically a simple code, okay? For example, n is 10 now and n is not equal to 0, so break won't work. So, the line will get printed, first line will get printed and n value will be 9. Again, while loop will go. So, the while loop doesn't hold the main place in the condition over here. So, it just it's used to iterate the process, but the main condition is over here. So, this decides whether to continue or terminate the loop. This simple break statement can do a much greater change. Okay, so last thing to do, just close the file. So, close F. Okay, I think we are good to go now. So just copy this piece of code, copy it, and go to Ripple. Okay, so for just going here, just type Ripple ID Linux and go and sign in with your Google account. Okay, so just create, go here and create a new Ripple. So we need a bash one. So it's here bash. And something, name it something. Head command. And just click create Ripple. So your online Ripple will be created for you. And you can access it anytime, anywhere. Okay, that's the advantage of using this. So it's getting ready and it's connected. So we have our Linux terminal over here and we just do pwd. So as you can see here, we have the root, this is the root directory and we are in this head cum directory over here. So we will be just creating a C folder and a .c file and a, not C folder, .c file and a text file, okay? So for creating touch and it's going to be my program, my pro.c. And as you can see, mypro.c is created and let's also create a text file. So touch txt1.txt will be the name of the text file and hit enter. And as you can see, I have created my text file over here. Just add some values. So I'm just put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, like this till some 15. Okay. And here I will just paste the code over here. Okay, so I've done with the code. Okay, so now if I just run it and check whether it's in any error, so it's going to be gcc my program name dot c my pro dot c. Okay, there's some error. Okay, it's okay, not equal to 4, it's not equal to file, it's actually file f because we are using f4 here, so it's f. Okay, so I'll just run it again and see. So it's saying print some error, so it's print f. Did some mistakes happens. So mypro.c again, here we go. Okay, so now there isn't any error. So now if you just do dot slash a dot out and we're going to give the file name, so it's going to be txt1 dot with the extension txt. And as you can see here, we are getting the first 10 lines. Okay, so our file has about 15 lines and we are getting just the content specified in the first 10 lines. So that's it. We have successfully implemented the head command by using C program. And I also learned many commands. I've done about touch pwd and also many Linux commands. Do check out video list of and also learned C, C++, Java, Blender, Unity also. Please do check my other videos and subscribe and support me. And thanks for watching.